And good afternoon. It's me, Polly Hale Mealy with Abundant Health and Wellness. We are a holistic clinic located in downtown Humble, Main Street, and Avenue C. Now, this is not my regular time to be on Facebook Live, so I'm not even going to wait for people to tune in because I do this every Friday at noon. But there's something that's been bothering me for a whole week. I have a lot of young people who have young babies, and I see that they ask questions on Facebook about what do you do when the baby is so congested, or the toddler is so congested, or the young person is so congested that they just can't breathe. And so I'm reading all of these comments: do Benadryl, do baby sign off, do baby Claritin, whatever the deal is. And it's like, you know what? People just don't have any idea what's going on with mucus. So I want to give you a little bit of insight into what's going on with your baby or your infant or your toddler and help you get to the root of the problem and not drug your baby and not make a bad situation worse. So let me start out by saying that mucus is the body's natural way to coat, dilute, and take out of the body pathogens in the body. So mucus can happen when we are sick. Mucus can happen when there is an allergic reaction. So the fact that we have mucus is a sign that the immune system is doing what the immune system wants to do. Now, I'm just going to give you some background, personal background, so you know that I know what I'm talking about. When I was much, much younger and I was pregnant with my second child, we moved from an apartment into a home in the Houston area. Now, the home was beautiful, but the owners of the home, the previous owners, had big, big dogs. And we know they had big dogs because they had big stains on the carpet, okay? So we had to get people to come in and clean up the stains, but we also did not know that the dogs were infested with fleas. And so we would have an outbreak of fleas every 2 to 3 weeks. I mean, it was just horrible. I was pregnant. I had a toddler myself. And so it was one of those things that what do? You call the organ man and he comes and he does his thing because you don't know any different. And so I will just tell you, we lived in that house for approximately 6 months. It was all I could stand. And we had the Terminix guy come out multiple times. If I said 20 times, I don't think that would be an exaggeration. Every 2 weeks he would come out and spray the house. Now, during that time, I developed something called allergic rhinitis because of all the chemicals in my home. I'm sure it didn't help my children, but I didn't know any better, okay? And so what do? I go to the doctor and he says, you have allergic rhinitis. And so he gives me stuff to dry up the sinuses, to dry up the mucus. He gives me a steroid shot so that I can breathe. And he gives me an antibiotic for the infection, okay? Remember, I didn't know any better. And so that started a more than 20-year run of me having sinus issues every single day of my life. And so I know what it is with the mucus issues. I mean, I tried and true, I know what to do about this. And so because I did not know back in the day, I would take every morning because I would wake up with a blinding headache, lots of congestion, and I could not breathe. So I would take every morning, it was in my nightstand, and I would take whatever, either sign off or Claritin or whatever was on sale at the drugstore that would open up the sinuses, I would take that every day. And about an hour after I got up, I would be fine. I could breathe and whatever. And then the next day we'd start it all over again. Now, I thought this was the way I had to live my life, but thank God, somebody who knew something about holistic health pulled me to the side and said, did you know that every time you take a chemical prescription or over the counter, what you are doing is you are drying up the mucus, but you are also drying up all of those pathogens right inside your tissues. And it was like, oh my gosh, I did not know that. And she said, yes, you take that medicine and you feel better and you can breathe and you think that you're well, but what you have done, you have the sinus tissue with all of those pathogens, right? And so the next time your sinuses flare up and mucus flares up, not only are you dealing with that day's pathogens, but you're dealing with everything that's gone on before. And so that was very, very disheartening to me, because I thought, for 20 years I have done this, right? And so my practitioner helped me to start doing some things that I needed to do. And I'm going to tell you what she told me so that you can do this too. And you can do this with your babies, okay? So number one, you want to make sure that anytime there is mucus, the mucus is clear and the mucus is thin. If the mucus is thin, running, post-nasal drip, that kind of thing, which is more of an allergy reaction, you're going to want to take something like elderberry, because elderberry will dry it up. If you have congestion, if you've got pressure, you've got the snuffles, you can't breathe, and that kind of thing, and we know babies, we hear them kind of snort because they can't breathe. What's happened is their sinuses are so full of mucus that there's just no way for them to breathe. So what you want to do is you want to give them an herb called bayberry, B-A-Y-B-E-R-R-Y. It is an herbal tincture. We get all of our tinctures from the Pure Herbs Company. If you let me know you want to do that, I can send you a form. You can order actually at wholesale pricing. And we really want you to do this, because one of the things we want young parents to do is to have an arsenal of herbs at home. So when the little one gets ill, you've got everything at your fingertips, and all you have to do is just call us and say, Dr. Polly, this is going on, what do you suggest? And you've got everything right there. And so that's really what we want for you. So if the baby cannot breathe, if the mucus is thick, if the mucus starts to turn yellow, then you've got an infection going. God forbid it goes green. You don't want it to go green. So if you've got mucus that is green, you have got a really big infection, a sinus infection, or maybe upper respiratory infection. And so you need to get that taken care of. Now, if it's already green, you're probably going to have to take the baby to the doctor and get a good antibiotic, which of course we don't like, because the antibiotic kills all the good bacteria in the baby's gut. So you're going to have diarrhea and all that other kind of stuff, and the baby's going to be more susceptible to any other kind of pathogen. So we don't really want that. But what we want you to do is have this arsenal on hand, so at the first sign of anything going wrong, you give the baby natural antibiotics, natural antivirals. You get the congestion released with the bayberry, or you get it dried up with the elderberry, and you never are going to have a problem. So please, please, please listen to me, and don't give your babies prescriptions. Don't give your babies over-the-counter things, because what that does is it dries up the mucus. Yes, the baby can breathe. Yes, but you're drying up all those pathogens inside. What we would rather you do is you liquefy that mucus. That mucus goes through the body, through the lymphatic system, and the baby doesn't have a problem. And these things can be done from 1 year and under, all the way up until you're 100. It just is a different dosing. So hopefully this has helped you. Hopefully, you can write this down. If you need to get an application to order these herbs, certainly call our office. We'll gladly email that to you and help you. And this is me signing off. I've taken about 10 minutes of your time, but hopefully you've benefited from this public service announcement. And I'm very, very distressed that we've got all these babies going around that they can't breathe. So this is my gift to you, so that you can get your little baby to breathe. Take care. Love you. And I will talk to you tomorrow at our regularly scheduled time. Bye-bye.